Good morning, guys. So it's noon. It's not even morning. I'm getting ready to have a cup of coffee and make us some pizza dough. I found a recipe online for supposedly Lou Malnati's deep dish Chicago style pizza. So that's what we're going to try today. I have a good recipe that I kind of made on my own one time. But I found this recipe on chowhound.com in the comment section. This guy seems to know what he's talking about. So, I have to let my dough rise for 6 hours. So, let me get my hands washed and get everything laid out here. And let's make us some pizza dough. For my coffee, y'all know I love the Coffee Mate Creamy Chocolate. I've been using this. It's the Natural Bliss in chocolate. Drizzle of that. And then, of course, a little bit of half and half, right? And it tastes so good. This is that Kauai coffee, the light roast. It's good, too. So good. Alrighty. So, we are going to add in 1 cup of all-purpose flour. I have this organic one. 6 to 7 tablespoons of water. He said he uses 6.5, and I have already measured out my water. That's 6.5 tablespoons of water. 3 tablespoons of oil. I think Lou Malnati uses corn oil, so that's what I got. And then 3/4 teaspoon. Of active dry yeast, and then 1/2 teaspoon of sugar and 1/2 teaspoon of salt. We mix it for 1 minute and then we knead it for no more than 2 minutes, and we have to let this rise for 6 hours. Okay, so I'm gonna get everything poured in the bowl and I'll be back. So 1 cup flour, 6.5 tablespoons of water, 3 tablespoons of corn oil, 1/4 kosher salt, so there's 1/4, 1/2, 3/4. It doesn't look like much, but it should puff up pretty good. I only have 1 deep dish pizza pan, so that's what I'm going to use. I got it several years ago, and it's what I used in my last deep dish Chicago style pizza. So hopefully it's enough. I don't even know what it is, like 12 inch or 14 inch. I don't know. Okay, and now we're going to knead this for 2 minutes. Alright, so since I am going to make a second batch of this just to be safe, I'm going to let my dough rise in this bowl. And so anytime you let dough rise, you just want to do like a drizzle of olive oil, any kind of oil, I guess. And you just want to turn your dough in it and coat it to let it rise. I mean, just a drizzle, okay? Not much at all. And then, let me grab some cling wrap. Cover your bowl with some saran wrap. This is a Christmas saran wrap, that's why it's red. And then you just want to top it with a kitchen towel and just let it do its thing, okay? So I'm gonna set it over here. And since I've never made this recipe before, just to be safe, I'm gonna make a second dough ball. Worst come to worst, we can make 2 pizzas tonight, honey, I don't know. So I'm gonna go ahead and do the same exact thing and let it rise in this bowl. Getting the girls some food made up. I'm doing chicken and beef with rice. Doing a big batch because I want this to last about a week, if it will. Does it smell good? She just wants her mommy. She don't want the food. She just wants mom. Don't you, babe? Okay. Let's do a little bit of a haul. How does that sound? Oh. Guys, I never really want a new eyeshadow palette. I've wanted this for so long. So I'm thinking about doing a first impressions video tomorrow. Maybe, if I have time. So right off, the palette looks very pretty. Very nice. Let's see how big it is in terms of with one of their standard Morphe palettes. Alright, so just slightly bigger. Not much at all. Okay. Width-wise, we're looking about the same. But I will say, I like the cardboard packaging better than the plastic. Go ahead and toss this. I've been waiting so long to feel these and to see what they're like. Let's go in first with Pool Party. Oh my lord, it feels wet. Let's go in with Jada, because that one always looks a little iffy to me. What? My gosh. Guys, these are beautiful. I want to try this purple out. And the blue. Collection. I love warm looks on the eye anyway. Oh gosh. You're beautiful. I'm getting ready to leave for my trip to Florida. But if I have time, I'm going to really do a makeup look tomorrow maybe. I'm going to try. In my last Sephora play box, I had received the Milk Makeup Blur Stick. I fell in love with it. That did so good for my pores. So, honey, I got me the full size. And so I think my coupon code was SUMMERSCORE, I think. But you get a 10-piece sample set. So I got a Makeup Forever Ultra HD Foundation. Get 4 different shades in that. Really good size of those two. The Anastasia Dip Brow Pomade. I've used this for years. Got 4 shades to sample there. Got a Bite Agave Lip Mask. I've actually never tried this, and so many people talk about it. And I didn't realize it comes in 3 shades now. So, can't wait to try that. Got the Tarte Maracuja Creaseless Concealer Sample in 4 different shades. I know. Let me do this real quick. Got a Lancôme Lash Primer. Got a sample of the Urban Decay eyeshadow primers in 4 of the shades. The original Eden Minor Sin and Anti-Aging. I don't like the anti-aging one. I have the full size of it. I thought that sounded great. I don't think that it primes your lids as good as the other ones. Got a Becca Shimmering Skin Perfector in Champagne Pop. Believe it or not, I've never tried this, so I really can't wait to try that. NARS Laguna, my Holy Grail Bronzer. Got a couple of the Hourglass Ambient Lighting Powders. I have all of them. My favorite is the Luminous Light is my favorite. And I also really like Diffused Light, which is this one. I like to put that kind of under the eyes. And the last thing that I got in that was the Marc Jacobs Highliner Gel Crayon in black. And I've already went through a whole one of these in the past, and I do love that eyeliner. So wonderful coupon code if you can still get your hands on it. And so the Bite Agave Lip Mask comes in Champagne, Natural, and Smashed. I think Natural was the only one that I was really aware of, but I think Champagne looks really nice too. All of them do. Can't wait to try it. Yes. So since I have full sizes of the ambient lighting powders and the NARS Laguna, I'm going to let my mom have those because she uses those little sample cards all the time. She loves them. And I'm actually going to let her have this. I really wasn't impressed with this palette. Were you guys? This is the Morphe 25A. What was this called? Copper Spice or Mocha? I don't know. I think this is the Copper Spice one. But I'm just going to see if, I think my mom will use this. It's not a horrible palette. I just didn't think it was great. My favorite Morphe palette that I've had before the Jaclyn Hill palette was the 35F. It's the Fall into Frost palette. And it's full of all of those metallic shadows. It's got a row of matte ones as well, but I love metallic eyeshadows. Y'all know it's my favorite. So that, in my opinion, is 10 times better than this other little palette. Starting to pack. Just get some stuff put together for the trip. We are going to have a couple of days in the water, so I'm going to take 2 suits, my new pajamas, a couple of cover-ups, and David's already started getting some of his stuff together, so I'm going to be using our new suitcase that we just got. I really love it. It's so light, and you'll be able to really feel it full. And I got the bright kind of Kentucky blue. That way we could know it was our suitcase coming off the belt, you know? Like, you want something that's going to stick out. This will stick out, hopefully. So I'm going to go ahead and toss in a little bit of stuff. And my poor angel. Don't be sad. Don't be sad. Hey, guys. So it is 12:25 a.m. I went out and checked the mail like a little while ago. And my bras came. I ordered 3 new bras. And I thought I would show you those. These are like everyday bras. I have fancy bras. These are my everyday, okay? And I get them from Cacique. I don't know. Tell us what they're called here. Yes, the satin full coverage, okay? And I thought I seen a price tag. $36.50, okay? But just good, basic, supportive nude bras. Like, that's what you need for the daily, right? I also really love animal print, so I got this one. Let me see what it's called. Okay, this one is called the Smooth Balconette, and it was $39.50. But I just thought that print was just so pretty, like a snow leopard or something. So I think this one is just so pretty. Like the little pink bow in the middle. I'm going to get ready to go to bed. David had to run to Prestonsburg tonight to do a couple of things. And while he was already out with his friend Brandon, they went ahead and went gambling. So I did not make the pizzas. I will do that tomorrow and show you all how I plan on making my Chicago deep dish pizza. Okay? So I'm going to hit the hay. And guys, I will see you tomorrow.